you're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, UK, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat. In English, Punjabi and Gujarati, with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Prerna Sharma and today's headlines are: In India, security forces have killed Jammu and Kashmir IS chief, and an 11-year-old has made history as the first Indian ball girl at FIFA World Cup. In UK, a female ISIS supporter has been sentenced to life imprisonment, and a US diplomat believes that US President Donald Trump's London itinerary will include the Queen. In Punjab, youths detained in the US are allegedly being served inedible food, and jathedars of all 5 Takht Sawas Gurdwaras to curb speaker sound. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, UK and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: 4 militants, including the head of the Islamic State Jammu and Kashmir, have been killed during a gunfight with security forces in Jammu and Kashmir's Anantnag district. A policeman and a civilian were also killed in the exchange of fire between militants and security forces in Srigupwara. 11-year-old Nathania John from Tamil Nadu has become India's first FIFA ball girl when she led Brazil onto the field in their game against Costa Rica at Arena St. Petersburg. Nathania, who hails from the Nilgiris, is a footballer herself. She got the opportunity to travel to the FIFA World Cup after winning a contest. Jammu and Kashmir Governor N.N. Bohra has chaired an all-party meeting of mainstream political parties where measures to restore peace in the state have been discussed. Leaders assured Bohra full support but asserted that efforts must be focused on holding early elections so that a democratic government takes office in the state. The Seychelles Parliament will not ratify a pact allowing India to build naval facilities on one of the archipelago's islands. Opposition lawmakers argue that allowing India access to the island of Assumption would be surrendering territory to another country, and joint management of the facility with India undermine the 115 island nation sovereignty. The UIDAI has asserted that the use of Aadhaar biometric data for criminal investigation is not allowed under the Aadhaar Act. A day earlier, the NCRB made a case for limited Aadhaar data access for the police to crack crime. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has cancelled her China visit as political meetings at the appropriate level were not confirmed by the Chinese government. She was scheduled to lead a delegation under the exchange program of the Government of India with the International Department of the Communist Party of China. The Uttarakhand High Court has banned all water sports including white river rafting and paragliding across the state. This is until the state government does not come out with a policy to regulate these activities in tune with the safety of the people indulging in the sport and also the environment. Former Indian cricketer Sachin Tendulkar finds that the use of 2 new balls in ODI cricket is the perfect recipe for disaster. The former Indian skipper made the remarks in relation to the highest ever ODI total scored by England against Australia on Tuesday. The latest health statistics paint a grim picture of India's mental health, revealing that one person commits suicide every 4 minutes. The National Health Profile 2018 raises alarm over the increasing number of suicide deaths, a whopping 1,33,623 in a year. It also shows increasing vulnerability of Indian men vis-a-vis women. Actor Ayushmann Khurrana, who has carved a niche for himself in just 6 years in Hindi filmdom, says he's loving his space in Bollywood. He rose to fame with Vicky Donna and then starred in enduring films like Dam Laga Ke Hai Sha and Shubh Mangal Savadhan, which entertained with a message. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from UK and Punjab followers. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from UK are: A Moroccan-origin Islamic State supporter, Rizlane Bolar, who is behind UK's first all-female terrorist attack plot, has been sentenced to life imprisonment. Bolar has been awarded with a minimum term of 16 years behind bars after she admitted helping her 22-year-old daughter in a sinister plan. Deputy Chief of Mission Liu Liukins at the US Embassy in London believes that President Donald Trump will meet Queen Elizabeth II during his visit to Britain next month. He also claimed that planning for the July trip was delayed due to Trump's summit with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un last week. The police have arrested a man at London's Charing Cross railway station who claimed that he had a bomb. The police are now working to reopen the station as soon as possible. Britain is currently on its second highest threat level of severe, meaning an attack by militants is imminent. Scotland's Brexit Minister Michael Russell has claimed that Holyrood will not give consent to any further Brexit legislation until the broken devolution system is fixed. Brussels said that the Scottish government no longer trusts UK ministers after they pushed through the Brexit bill last week. The House of Commons has spent around £2.4 million on gagging clauses for former staff since 2013. 53 departing members signed contracts compelling them not to reveal information about the Commons. The non-disclosure agreements can be used to silence victims of bullying or harassment. The Commons Justice Committee has claimed that the system for supervising criminals in England and Wales is in a mess after reforms failed to meet aims. The committee is not convinced that reforms could ever deliver an effective probation service. The European Union has introduced retaliatory tariffs on US goods as a top official launched a fresh attack on President Donald Trump's trade policy. The duties on US goods worth £2.8 billion came into force recently. The Commons Environmental Audit Committee is set to investigate a rise in cheap, disposable clothes and their impact on the environment. Fast fashion can release toxic chemicals in production and plastic fibers in the wash. A latest report suggests that about 300,000 tons of clothing is binned in the UK each year. Union officials have accused Transport Secretary Chris Grayling of running scared after he pulled out of a conference on transport in the north. Grayling was due to speak at a summit in Manchester but will now take part in a parliamentary debate about a third runway at Heathrow. Prince Charles has met the police officer who fell ill after being exposed to the nerve agent used on a Russian ex-spy and his daughter. Surgeon Nick Bailey was left seriously ill after responding to the attack on Sergei Skripal and Yulia Skripal in Salisbury in March. I'll be back. Stay locked on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Punjabi youths detained at the Otero County Processing Center in the US are being served poor quality food and are living in bad conditions. They're currently facing deportation. The mother of one of the youths has claimed that 22 Punjabi youths had gone on a 15-day fast in May protesting over the issue. Jathedars of all five takhts have issued an edict asking all Gurudwaras to turn loudspeakers off during Ardas and limit the sound within the premises. The PPCB has hailed the decision and it will now ask other religious institutions to ensure that the level of noise pollution is kept in check. SAD has condemned the attack on Aam Aadmi Party MLA Amarjeet Singh Sandoa and demanded a judicial inquiry. The SAD BJP delegation has also submitted a memorandum to Governor VP Singh Badnor urging a judicial inquiry into the murderous assault on forest officials by the Sand Mafia. Power consumers in rural areas of the state will now have to shell out more money from their pockets. The 10 to 15 paisa per unit hike in tariff caused by the 2% increase in electricity duty will be in retrospective effect from April 1st. The attack on Aam Aadmi Party MLA Amarjeet Singh Sandoa is not an isolated case of brazenness of the mining mafia in the district. On May 11, Constable Jaswant Singh along with his colleagues were attacked after they had stopped a tipper loaded with sand illegally dug up near Kiratpur Sahib police station. Infighting in the Aam Aadmi Party turned ugly when the party's state co-convener Balbir Singh and leader of opposition Sukhpal Singh Khera took on each other at a press conference. Khera left the press conference in a huff soon after the media pushed the leaders for their comments on the Sikh referendum issue. The Punjab and Haryana High Court has ruled that mere allegations of an accused petitioner being influential is not enough for a court to reject his bail plea. The statement came while granting anticipatory bail to Punjab Superintendent of Police Raj Balwinder Singh. The state has announced 40 crore rupees for land acquisition for a railway line between Patti and Makhu in Firozpur. The decision was conveyed to a delegation of traders and industrialists led by Cabinet Minister O.P. Soni. The Punjab Public Service Commission has agreed to change the negative marking criteria. The Punjab and Haryana High Court had recently observed that the provision for negative marking for candidates raising objections to wrong answer keys in the selection of 118 Ayurvedic medical officers was arbitrary. More than 1.5 years after Prime Minister Narendra Modi laid foundation stone, the work on the AIIMS has finally begun in Bathinda. The project is estimated to be constructed on 177 acres on the outskirts of Bathinda at a cost of 925 crore rupees. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-UK businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Bollywood star Priyanka Chopra arrived early on Friday with American singer-songwriter Nick Jonas amid speculation that they are more than just friends. Priyanka tried evading the paparazzi at the airport with a black curtain in the back seat, maintaining privacy for the passengers. While the cameras could only capture slight glimpses of the two, they were seen later while emerging out of a car. The actress, who became popular in American showbiz with a lead role in Quantico, has been creating a buzz with her appearance with Jonas. In December last year, Jonas, while promoting Jumanji: Welcome to the Jungle, had expressed a desire to visit India. Jonas had said in a statement to IANS, "I've never been to India, but I'm dying to go, and I have now heard from Priyanka, my new friend, a lot about it. Just given me a lot of names of places to go if I go there." A few days ago, they walked arm in arm at Jonas's cousin's wedding in New Jersey. From Black Friday to Gangs of Fazepur to Urta Punjab to Lust Stories, Anurag Kashyap wants to start a conversation on several social issues with his cinema. He says he makes films to evoke and provoke. "I always want my cinema to strike a conversation. I make films to evoke and provoke, and that usually leads to a conversation," Kashyap told IANS over an email. His project Lust Stories shows stories on love and lust and has garnered a positive response. The director says it is time to have a conversation around the subject of sex. He says his sports film like Mukkabaz, which deals with the struggle of a boxer and with social issues, holds a special place in his heart.